Good day, everyone. Welcome to Prayer Watch. Thank you for joining us today. Let us now begin with our word of prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, our Father in heaven, we praise you and we thank you, Lord, for this beautiful day. We ask you, O God, to be with us again as we look into your word that is true, your word that is life. We pray, Lord, that Holy Spirit will abide with us and will provide for us spiritual wisdom for your spiritual words. Father, thank you, O God, that you are a God who promises us things that will be for our ultimate good. We pray, O God, that as we listen and as we reflect upon your words, we will be filled with so much faith and hope. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah.
hope. Hope is such a positive attitude. It's a positive word. Just the mere mention of hope lights up our mood and lifts up our spirits. Here is a definition of the word that I came across with. And it says, hope is an optimistic state of mind that is based on an expectation of positive outcomes with respect to events and circumstances in one's life or the world at large. We say we have hope that things will get better, hope that we will recover, hope associated with a promise to be fulfilled. A parent exerts effort in the hope of providing a better future for his child. We plan for various goals with the hope that we will be able to attain them at some point in time. As a verb, hope means to trust, to anticipate, to wish. And so hope is positive, future-oriented. It is trust. In the Bible, the Hebrew word for hope is more than just a dream. It is an expectation and an expression of faith. It means to wait or to be patient, such as in Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31, that says, but those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. In some other versions, it says, but those who wait on the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. That is a strong, positive outlook, as well as a confident promise based on trust in God. The Old Testament, especially the Psalms, have many such messages about hope. Psalm 62, verse 5 says, yes, my soul, find rest in God. My hope comes from Him. Truly, He is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I will not be shaken. Likewise, the New Testament is a treasure trove of lessons about hope in God. Romans 15:13 declares, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. What this verse is saying is that God is the God of hope. He is the source of hope. And because He is the source of hope, then hope is God's gift, which makes joy, peace, and trust possible. Hope is a miraculous attitude. It sustains us when the odds are against us, and not only enables us to endure the present suffering or adversity, but to withstand them with joy and peace and more trust in God. And so because of this, we must keep this gift of hope alive in us. Why? Well, first, because we can rest assured and secure in God's love for us. This is what we read in Romans 5:5. And hope does not put us to shame because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. And so the Holy Spirit is the spirit of hope. It is God who gives us hope. The same God who lavishes His love upon us, His children. His children because we believe in Jesus Christ. We put our hope and trust in these words of the Lord for us. How true it is that our hope in God is not in vain. When we think about His love, how He has saved us spiritually, and how He carried us through our problems, sufferings, burdens, sorrows, and struggles in the past. We can attest to the truth that we had not hoped in vain. We are standing now stronger, closer to God, and more mature Christians today because we put our hope in God. Another reason why we must keep our hope alive is because God has plans for our ultimate good. God's words for the Israelites then can also be applied to us now. In Jeremiah 29 verse 11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." Plans to give you hope and a future. These plans of God for our ultimate good must give us hope. Plans to give us hope and plans to give us a future. Part of God's love for us is His plans for our ultimate good. We say ultimate good because although we are children of God, we are imperfect. And in our imperfection, we make bad choices. So we find ourselves veering away from God's good plans for us. And so the journey towards that plan, that good plan for God, can look bad, can look dim and gloomy at the present time because of our imperfections. Or, although we may do what is right, at times other people don't. And so we are adversely affected by their actions, which delay or divert God's good plans. But what this verse is saying is that God's plans for His people are always for their ultimate good. At the end of the storm, at the end of the tunnel, is the fulfillment of God's good plans. There are snags or hurdles along the way, but in the end, God's good plans and plans for our good will prevail. And so keep hoping and waiting with faith in the future good outcome, whatever be your situation right now, because it is just a matter of time. And of course, it is a matter of obedience. As Psalm 3 verses 2 to 3 says, "Many are saying to me, God will not deliver him. But you, Lord, are a shield around me, my glory, the one who lifts my head high." Third and last, we must keep our hope alive because God will carry His plans to completion when we call on Him and seek Him with all our heart. When we say seek Him and call upon Him with all our heart, that means with hope. What is the basis of this principle? Let's read what follows after Jeremiah 29 verse 11 that we just mentioned earlier. Jeremiah 29 verses 12 to 14 says, "Then you will call on me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. I will be found by you, declares the Lord." This tells us how we can keep our hope in God's alive, and that is by seeking Him in prayer and in His Word, in Scriptures. For instance, when we are in the midst of some kind of suffering because of sickness or injury, or because we are under pressure in some oppressive situation in the workplace, or brought about by some predicament where we seem helpless, we can wait in hope because we hope in God's word and in His answer to our prayer. God's promises are the basis of our hope. God says, "Come to me, call on me, pray to me, because I am listening, and I will answer, and I will sustain you until you overcome your troubles." Psalm 3, verses 4 to 6 declares, "I will call out to the Lord, and He answers me from His holy mountain. I lie down and sleep. I wake again, because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear, though tens of thousands assail me on every side." Like the psalmist, when we call out to the Lord to help us, when we seem to be surrounded by people or situations that are against us, we can take one day at a time. We can sleep and wake again because God sustains us daily until we are able to cross over to the other side of our situation. We can face our fears with courage because our hope in God is alive. Each day and each step that we take, held by God's hand, will bring us slowly out of our problems and into God's ultimate good for our life. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, is there anything that needs hope in your situation right now? Take God's gift of hope. Hope in God. Hope in His Word. Pray with hope. He is the only one in whom we can put our trust 100%. And that trust will not disappoint us. If you ride in this sea of hope, this overwhelming hope from the Lord, you will also receive the waves of joy and peace and even more hope flowing into your heart and flowing out to others until you reach the good shore of His plans for you. Let us pray. Dear God, the God of hope, the God of peace and joy, the God who is faithful, our Father in heaven, we receive with faith and with so much excitement the continuing hope that wells up within us, Lord, through the ministry of your Holy Spirit who is in us. Thank you so much, O God, that there is no end to this hope for as long as it takes for us to make it from this point to the next. Thank you, Lord, that your promises can be trusted because you are a God who is true. And we have experienced you, O Lord, how you have saved us from so many of our troubles and how we should keep this hope alive because we know you are a God who never changes. Father, thank you for ministering to our hearts today. Thank you, Father, that our hope is not in vain. Thank you that you will, in fact, answer our prayers in ways that are even much more than we have asked for much more than we have hoped for. In Jesus' name, amen. Goodbye, everyone, for now, and until we see each other again, I hope you have a very pleasant and blessed day.